नमस्ते। यन्मण्डलं दीप्तिकरं विशालं रत्नप्रभं तीव्रमानादिरूपं दारिद्र्यदुःखक्षयकारणं च पुनात्मां तत्सवितुर्वरेण्यम्। वेलकम टू दिस प्रेजेंटेशन। टुडे आई विल बी स्पीकिंग ऑन एन इम्पोर्टेंट टॉपिक विच ऑल द फिजिशियंस इन द फील्ड ऑफ आयुर्वेदा must be aware of and should be serious in following the same in clinical practice, that is aushadha sevana kala. At the outset, let me thank everyone who have joined me and especially the organizers of Ayurveda Network Banaras Hindu University for coming out with this series of lectures. So let us begin. I have given the title for today's presentation as a critical analysis of Aushadha Sevana Kala with special reference to chronopharmacology. I'm sure that all of us know about Aushadha Sevana Kala. We know its significance and importance. But unfortunately, most of the practitioners are not following Aushadha Sevana Kala in their clinical practice. There may be several reasons for this. As the science advanced in the contemporary field, maybe in the field of modern pharmacology, medicine, etc., they have understood the importance of time of administration of the medicine. So now they have a separate discipline in their scientific branch by the name chronopharmacology, chronotherapeutics, chronobiology, etc. Let us try to understand our own concept first, and then let us have a parallel discussion of these concepts that are revalidated in modern pharmacology. Considering the length of topic, I will be dealing with this title in 2 to 3 parts. So let me start with the first part now. There is a statement in Charaka Samhita which you must have already read: kalo hi bhaisajya prayoga paryaptim abhinirvartayati. Acharya Agnivesha has mentioned that it is the kala. Here kala specifically refer to the time of administration of the medicine. Kalo hi भैषज्य प्रयोग पर्याप्तिम अभिनिर्वर्तयति। Accomplishment of action of the medicine that is administered is decided by the time, that is the success of therapeutic action of the medicine is greatly decided by the time at which it was administered. Same title was used in one of the dissertations carried out by my senior Dr. Yogita Gayakwad at IPGT and RIA Jamnagar, where she evaluated this concept of Aushadha Sevana Kala by taking one example of Kasa and another example of Udavarta. Accordingly, she had taken a medicine and administered it in 2 different Aushadha Sevana Kala and evaluated the differences in clinical subjects also, and she could establish the importance of Aushadha Sevana Kala. This is a well-known statement from Apamarga Tanduliya Adhyaya of Charaka Samhita, where Acharya states, Matra Kalashraya Yuktihi Siddhir Yukto Pratishthita Tishtatyuparyuktijnaha Dravya Jnanavatam Sada. Here, Siddhi refers to Chikitsa Siddhi, success in the treatment. Siddhihi Yukto Pratishthita. Success in the treatment depends on Yukti, that is Yojana, planning of the therapy. How well a physician has planned the treatment, it decides the success of the treatment. This Yuktihi depends upon Matra and Kala. Matra Kala Shraya Yuktihi. That means proper planning of the medicine based on the posology or the dose and time of administration decides the success of the treatment. So he emphasizes that Tishtati Upari Yuktijnaha Dravyajnanavatam Sada. A physician who just has the knowledge of medicines only but doesn't know how to plan the medicine in the patients is not much regarded. A physician, in addition to the knowledge of Dravya, who is Yuktijna, who can plan the medicine properly in clinical practice, always stands superior. So this once again highlights the importance of Aushadha Sevana Kala. When we talk about the term Aushadha Sevana Kala, we do find many terminologies which are giving similar meanings. Like Bhaishajya Kala, Aushadha Kala, Bhaishajya Grahana Kala, Aushadha Avacharana Kala, Agada Kala, and Aushadha Vekshana Kala. So these are the various terminologies which are used in synonymous to the time of administration of the medicine. Let us see the definition here. Vaidyaka Shabda Sindhu states Aushadha Kalaha Aushadha Sevanasya Samaya. Proper time for administration of Aushadha is known as Bhaishajya Kala or Aushadha Sevana Kala. Let us introduce the topic. Aushadhi Sevana Kala is a type of Avasthika Kala. So that means, it means the proper time that is meant for drug administration. Agni is the most important factor here. While explaining Aushadha Sevana Kala, even though several factors are considered, it is the dosha, in that also Pancha Vata and Agni are given much more importance. Agni being the supreme factor for maintaining Dhatu Samy, all the therapies are directed to maintain and preserve the potency of the Agni. So the proper knowledge of Agni and food and the interaction of drug with Agni, drug with the food, interaction of the food with Agni, all these is helpful to attain a quick and sustainable relief to the patient. Now let us talk about the types of Aushadha Sevana Kala. There are different opinions among various texts. So whatever may be the opinions, there are similarities between them. In Charaka Samhita Chikitsa Sthana, chapter number 30, 10 types of Aushadha Sevana Kala are mentioned. Acharya Sushruta also has mentioned 10 types in Uttara Tantra, 64th chapter. Vagbhata in Ashtanga Hrudaya has mentioned Yunjadanannamannado Madhyente Kavalantare Grase Grase Mukukusannam Samuddham Nishichausha. Reference given in Ashtanga Sangraha looks to be the best one, which is more descriptive with a clear commentary by Acharya Indu. 11 Aushadha Sevana Kala are vividly explained here. So for my presentation, I have taken the reference mainly from Ashtanga Sangraha. Acharya Sharangadhara has mentioned फाइव टाइप्स ऑफ औषध सेवना काल ज्ञेयः पञ्चविधः कालः भैषज्य ग्रहणे नृण. What are the factors that are influencing chikitsa kala? When I talk about the factors, it may be dina, that is the diurnal aspects. For example, for vamana, prathakala is preferred. For anvasanamasti, after administration of light food. And another factor that is important is rugna or rogi. For example, prataha nirannakala administration is mentioned if person is balavan and there is kafodreka avastha. Aushadha is also very important. The type of medicine, whether it is churna or avaleha, depending upon that, we have samudga, sagrasa, grasantara type of aushadha sevanakala. Then roga or vyadhi, for example, jvara. Here, 6 hourly peya consumption is described. Then jirna linga or jirna lakshana, like laghuta, udgara, pradipta kshudha. These are all important, especially whenever you have to administer medicines like kashaya. Rutu or season is another important factor. For example, vasanta rutu where kapha prakopa is observed, accordingly aushadha sevana kala is selected. Now let us just have a tabular presentation of number of aushadha sevana kala mentioned by various authors. According to Charaka Samhita, as I already mentioned, bhuktadav, bhukta madhye, bhukta paschat, that is after prathama annakala and after dvitiya or sayam annakala, muhur muhu, samudga, bhakta sanyukta, sagrasa, grasantara, prataha, niranna. So these are mentioned. Bhuktadav for apana vikriti, bhukta madhye for samana vayu prakopa. In bhukta paschat, after food, after lunch or after prathama annakala, in vyana vayu vikara, after dinner or after sayam bhojana, udana vayu vikara, muhur muhuhu in shwasaka, satrishna, etc., samudga in hikka, bhakta sanyukta along with food in aruchi, sagrasa along with the bolus of the food in pranavayu vikriti, grasantara in between bolai or in between morsels in pranavayu vikriti again, prataha in balavan purusha, niranna but after lahu pratyahara, which is ideally recommended if it is durbala rugna. If it is balavan purusha, totally niranna in pratakala, that is in empty stomach. According to Sushruta Samhita, we have abhakta, pragbhakta, adhobhakta, madhyabhakta, antarabhakta, sabhakta, samugga, muhurmuhu, grasa, grasanta. The description is similar to other texts. So we will elaborately discuss this with the reference of Ashtanga Sangraha. According to Sharangadhara Samhita, there are panchavidha kala, kinchit suryodaye jate, tatha divasa bhojane, sayantane bhojane cha, muhuschapi tatha nishi. That is in morning hours, after sunrise in pitta javyadhi, kapha javyadhi, for virechana, vamana, lekhana purpose. After prathama annakala, divasa bhojana, that is related to that. If it is before food, bhojana purva, apana vikritav, sagrasa, with food aruchi, madhya bhukta or bhojana madhya in samana vayu vikriti, after food or bhojana paschati in vyana vikriti. So all these four are considered under divasa bhojana. In relation to sayam bhojana, maybe grasantara, sagrasa or bhojana paschati, in Udana Vayu Vikriti, Prana Vayu Vikriti respectively. Muhur Muhuhu in Trishna Charati, Hikka, Shwasa and Garavisha, with or without food. Nishi, that is at night at bed in Urdhva Jatruja Vikara for Lekhana or Brahmana purpose, both, most probably before dinner. So this is how Sharangadara mentions, and all these five Aushadha Sevanakala incorporate Dashavidha Aushadha Sevanakala mentioned by other scholars. Now let us go to the vivid, clear description given by Ashtanga Sangraha under the chapter Bheshajavacharaniyaha Trayovimshodhyayaha. First, let us understand the classical description with the help of commentary. Then later we will try to understand the science behind this based on certain scientific works that have been carried out. At the end we will contextually discuss chronopharmacology, chronotherapeutics and chronobiological aspects also. Tatra abhaktam nama kevalam eva aushadham. Author starts with abhakta. Abhakta means empty stomach, literally. Kevalam eva aushadham. Only aushadha is administered, no ahar. He says, nirannopayogat ativiryam kafodreka vimuktamashaya srotaha prataha balavan upayunjita itarastu pragbhaktadikam anna samsargena hitam na atiglanikaram bhavat. Nirannopayogat, as the medicine is administered in empty stomach without any contact with the food, ativiryam, it will show very potent action. Kafodreka, in kapha aggravated conditions. Vimuktamashaya srotaha, as previous nights or evening food is completely digested and bowels are passed, srotas will be empty and clear. So the action will be more potent. Prataha balavan upayunjita. Medicine has to be consumed in morning hours by a strong person who can withstand the potency of the medicine. Itarastu, other people who are weak, who are sensitive, are to be administered with the medicine pragbhaktadikam, in pragbhaktor, just before food, and other aushadha sevanakala, because anna samsargena hitam na atiglanikaram bhavati. Due to the contact with the food, person will not feel distress and it will be comfortable for a weak, sensitive person. Let us see how the commentary explains this. Tatra abhaktam yat bhaktena yogam nayati. Abhakta means where there is no contact with the food. Hi astane anne jirne tat aushadham upayujyate. Tasmincha jirne punarahara iti anannam. Astane anne jirne, previous meal, that is previous evening food, is digested and then aushadha is given in morning hours. Tasmincha jirne, after this medicine is digested, punaha ahara, food is given. So there is no interaction of food with the medicine. Previous food is digested and stomach is empty, then aushadha is given. Wait for aushadha to get digested and absorbed properly and then ahara is given. Tatcha niranna upayogat hetoho ativiryam bhavati. As I already mentioned, because of non-existence of contact with the food, ativiryam bhavati, drug will be very potent. Tatcha nirannam prataha purvahane kafodrekena vimukta amashaya srotaha san yama matrodgate ravau balavan purusha upayunjita. So most probably in a strong person in kapha aggravated conditions with the clear srotas, maybe after about one yama of sunrise, the medicine is administered. Itarastu abalaha प्राग्भक्तादिकं दशकं यथायोगं उपयुञ्जीत फॉर अदर्स हु आर अबल वीक स्टार्टिंग फ्रॉम प्राग्भक्त ऑल अदर 10 औषध काल कैन बी सिलेक्टेड अकॉर्डिंग टू द कंडीशन तत् हि अबलस्य अन्न संसर्गेण हेतुना न आत्मग्लानिकरं भवति एज़ ऑलरेडी मेंशन्ड Abalasya in weak persons, because of the contact with the food, there will not be any distress. Just to sum up, Bheshaja is administered in empty stomach. It's not mixed with the food. According to Hemadri, once the food consumed is to be digested and Bheshaja is given, and when Bheshaja is digested, food is given. According to Indu, after 1 yama or 3 hours of sunrise, Bheshaja is given. Here, activity is potent as there is no contact with the food. Agni and Bheshaja interaction will be unobstructed as there is absence of the food. Pradipta Agni is recommended here. Vyadhi should be Prabala Vyadhi. Patient should be Prabala Vyakti. Contraindicated in debility, children, pregnancy and females. In dosha kshayavastha and dhatu kshayavastha, there is a possibility of severe balakshaya and glani if you have not selected the patients accordingly. So amashaya and srotas will be rikta or empty or clear, so there will be direct interaction of Bheshaja with Agni. Now second aushadha sevana kala is pragbhakta. Pragbhaktam nama यत् अनंतर भक्तम् तत् अपानानिल विकृतौ अधकायस्य च बलाधानार्थम् तद्गतेषु च व्याधिषु प्रशमनाय कृषीकरणार्थं च योज्यम् यत् अनंतर भक्तम् मीन्स आफ्टर मेडिसिन इमीडिएटली फूड इज टू बी गिवन तत् अपानानिल विकृतौ कायस्य च बलाधानार्थम् तद्गतेषु च व्याधिषु प्रशमनाय कृषीकरणार्थञ्च योज्यम् 4 स्पेसिफिक इंडिकेशंस इन द डिजीजेस ड्यू टू द एग्रवेशन ऑफ अपानवाता सेकंड टू गिव स्ट्रेंथ और टू इंप्रूव स्ट्रेंथ टू द लोअर पार्ट ऑफ द बॉडी एज इन द केस ऑफ से पैराप्लीजिया वीकनेस इन लोअर लिम्स तद्गतेषु च व्याधिषु इन डिजीजेस पर्टेनिंग टू लोअर हाफ ऑफ द बॉडी मे बी ऑस्टियोआर्थ्रोसिस ऑफ द नी गृध्रसि लाइक कंडीशंस skin diseases pertaining to the extremities, especially lower extremities. Krishikaranarthancha, when person wants to lose his body weight and he wants to become slim, in such situations, Pragbhakta is the ideal time of administration. Same is elaborated in the commentary. Tatra Pragbhaktam nama yat anantara bhaktam. Anantaram paschad bhaktam yasya. तेनैतदुक्तं भवति यस्मिन् औषधे भुक्ते पश्चात् तत्कालमेव भक्तं युज्यते तत् प्राभक्ताख्यम् आफ्टर एडमिनिस्टरिंग द मेडिसिन इमीडिएटली फूड हैज टू बी गिवन नॉट आफ्टर अ सर्टेन गैप इफ इट इज आफ्टर सर्टेन गैप देन इट मे बिकम अभक्त और निरन्न हियर फूड हैज टू बी गिवन इमीडिएटली आफ्टर गिविंग द मेडिसिन तत्च अपानाख्यस्य अनिलस्य विकृतो अपान अनिल विकार मे बी उदावर्त मे बी विबंध विष्टब्ध और द डिजीजेस पर्टेनिंग टू जेनाइटो यूरिनरी ट्रैक्ट इन ऑल सच सिचुएशंस यू कैन सिलेक्ट दिस अधकायस्य बलाधानार्थम तथा तद्गतेषु अधकायगतेषु व्याधिषु प्रशमनाय देह कृषीकरणाय योज्यम् So just to sum the meaning, it is administered just before meals. According to Hemadri, Bheshaja intake is immediately followed by food. Ashupaka occurs of Bheshaja. Bheshaja gets digested quickly. There will not be any balakshaya because food follows Bheshaja. And there will not be any mechanical expulsion of Bheshaja because the food is given. Urdhvagati pratibandhaha. In apanavayu vikara, even in the patients who are weak, debilitated, in mutravaha purishavaha shukrava srotu vikara pakvashaya gata vyadhi arshas udabhramsha like conditions also we can follow. Next is madhya bhakta. Madhya bhaktam madhye bhaktasya tat samananina vikritam koshthagateshu cha vyadhishu paitikeshu cha. Madhye bhaktasya, in the middle of the meal, that is a part of the meal is consumed and then medicine is given, then remaining part of the food is consumed. It is not between two morsels. A few morsels are consumed so that half of the meal is consumed, then medicine is given and the remaining food is consumed. Tat samananina vikritam, it is indicated in samana vayu vikara. Koshtha gateshu cha vyadhishu, in the diseases pertaining to koshtha. Paitikeshu cha, in pittaja disorders also. Commentary says, madhya bhaktam nama yat bhaktasya madhye ardham bhojanam upayujya aushadham upayujyam punaha tatkalameva shishtam ardham iti. Half the amount of the food is consumed during one ahara kala, then medicine is given, tatkalameva, immediately remaining food is consumed. Tatcha samanakshasya anilasya vikritau tatha koshthagateshu vyadhishu paitikeshu apostagateshu piyujyam. Pittaja vikaras, even though they are not related to koshtha, we can follow this time of administration. To sum up, Bheshaja is administered in between the meals. According to both Chakrapani and Indu, half of the food is consumed, then Bheshaja, then remaining food. So Bheshaja acts mostly locally, eradicates sthanika doshas, stimulates samanavayu. In samanavayu vikriti, paitika disorders, in mandagni situations, in koshtagata vyadhi, pakvashagata vyadhi, also we can use it sometimes. In Shula, Gulma, Grahani like conditions, we can opt for this. It is observed that in Samanavayu and Pachaka Vitta Vikara, this time of administration is found to be very useful. Ahara or food here restricts Urdhva and Adhogati of Veshaja, so its main action will be local. Next is Adho Bhakta. It's almost opposite to the Prag Bhakta. Adho bhaktam bhaktat anantaram, that is immediately after food. Tattu vyana vikrito pratarashantam udana vikrito punah sayamashantam. So in the case of vyana vayu vikara, administration of medicine immediately after prataha bhojana, first meal, is considered. Adho bhakta can also be after evening meal or sayam bhojana, immediately after meal, then it is indicated in udana vayu vikara. Then purvakayasya cha baladhanartham tadgateshu vyadhishu cha shlaishmikeshu cha prashamanaya sthulikaranartham cha. Purvakayasya cha baladhanartham, to improve the strength of upper half of the body. If person has got weakness and difficulty in lifting the upper limb, if there is a condition like say Vishwachi, Apabahuka, etc., or diseases that are pertaining to upper half of the body, and if the person wants to improve his body weight in such situation, Adho Bhakta is the time of administration that is recommended. In the commentary, it is elaborated, Adho Bhaktam Nama Yat Bhaktat, that is Bhojanat Anantaram, tatkalameva upayujyate, after food immediately medicine is given. Tatcha vyana vikrito prata bhojananantaram karyam udana vikrito punah sayam bhojananantaram iti. Tat ubhaya kalani, here both the time of administration are to be considered, and in both situations purvakayasya uraha prabhritehe baladhanartham, to give strength to the chest and other upper part of the body. Tadgateshu purvakayastheshu cha vyadhishu, diseases that are pertaining to the upper half of the body. Then dehasya स्थूलीकरणाय च भवति. टू सम अप, भेषज इज एडमिनिस्टर्ड इमीडिएटली आफ्टर मील्स, मे बी आफ्टर लंच और आफ्टर डिनर, अकॉर्डिंग टू बोथ हेमाद्रि एंड इंदु. Administration of medicine immediately after food is important, not with a gap. After lunch in Vyanavayavikara, after dinner in Udanavayavikara. Activity of Bheshaja, if you are considering, the Udanavayu facilitates the Urdhvagati of Bheshaja, thereby strengthening the upper part, especially the sense organs. So in Vyanavayavikara, Udanavayavikara, the conditions like general debility, sarvanga shofa, jwara, depression in angamarda, like conditions in sarvangata kushta, visarpa, and especially upper part of the body, if you are administering in vyanavayu, maybe for the entire part of the body, chardi, aruchi, pinasa, galaganda, like conditions also we can opt this. Karsha is another indication. After lunch stimulates Vyanavayu, after dinner stimulates Udanavayu. Next is Sabhaktam. Sabhaktam yat annena samam sadhitam paschadva samalodhitam. So Sabhakta is, food is cooked along with the medicine. So while cooking itself, the medicine is added and cooked. So this practice was popular in this part of the country, like in this Udupi, Dakshina Kannada and a part of Kerala, where we used to call them as Maddina Ganji, where the medicinal herbs are added to rice and cooked and used. However, we have several Aushadha Siddha Yavagu like preparations also, where while cooking the food, medicine is incorporated. Or Paschadva Samalodhitam, food is already cooked and to that medicine is added and mixed and then administered. Where it is indicated, tat baleshu sukumareshu aushadha dveshisu aruchau sarvangadeshu cha rogeshu. In children and in people who are sensitive, delicate, and for those who have aversion to the food, who have the problem of palatability, and when the disease is spread throughout the body. सभक्तम नाम यत् अन्ने साध्यमाने दत्तम अन्नेन सहोपयुज्यते सिद्धे वा अन्ने पश्चातेन समानुड्य भुज्यते तत् उभयमपि बालादिषु. वेदर इट इज कुक्ड विद द फूड और एडेड आफ्टर प्रिपेयरिंग द फूड, इन बोथ द कंडीशंस फॉर बाला सुकुमार एटसेट्रा इट इज यूज्ड. इन अरुचि एंड व्हेन द डिजीज इज स्प्रेड थ्रू आउट द बॉडी, एज इन द केस ऑफ सर्वांगगत कुष्ठ अगेन or sarvangagata vata like conditions, so we can adopt this. So to repeat, bheshaja is mixed with the food and administered. According to Hindu, bheshaja is processed or cooked along with food. Activity of bheshaja is, it potentiates agnibala in arochaka, in sarvanga samsrishta vyadhi, in women, in elderly individuals, children, debilitated people, those who exhibit unpalatability to medicines, we can give this. We can expect a systemic action on the doshas and dhatus. The drug mixes with the rasadhatu and then spreads all over the body through urdhva, adaha and tiryak gati. So in sarvanga samshita vyadhi, we can use this. Next is antarabhaktam. Antarabhaktam yat पूर्वाह्ने भक्ते जीर्णे मध्याह्ने वेषजम् उपयुज्यते तस्मिश्च जीर्णे पुनरपराह्ने भोजनम् एतेन रात्रिर्व्याख्यात तत् दीप्ताग्नेः व्यानजेषु आमयेषु. अन्तराभक्तम् वी सिंपली कॉल इट एज़ इन बिटवीन फूड. इन बिटवीन फूड मीन्स यत् पूर्वाह्ने भक्ते जीर्णे, आफ्टर इ प्रातः भोजन इज डाइजेस्टेड, मेडिसिन इज गिवन. After the medicine is digested, evening food is given. So that is important. And similar pattern can be followed at night also. Deepta agnehe for agnidipana purpose. Vyana jeshu amayeshu, in vyana aggravated disease conditions also, we can follow this. If you see the commentary, same thing is elaborated. Antara bhaktam nama yat purvahne bhojanam upayujya. After purvahna bhojana or pata bhojana is given, because it's very important for us to keep in mind that according to Ayurveda, there are only two annakala, not three, four, five as we follow nowadays. Only two annakala are mentioned, pratha bhojana and sayam bhojana. That is why entire aushadha sevana kala is based on this. So, purvahne bhojanam upayujya, after consuming morning or pratha bhojana, tasmin jirne, after its digestion, madhyahne aushadham upayujyate, afternoon or noon medicine is given. Tasmin jirne, after medicine is digested, say in 2-3 hours or 4 hours, whatever it is, tadahareva punaha sayam bhojanam iti. Then sayam bhojana or evening meal is taken. Anena antarabhaksayam kalena nishopayujyamanasya aushadasya kalo vyakhyata. In evening also you can do the same type of aushadasevana kala. Nisha yasaushadasya kala uttaha tadevam upayujyate sayam bhukte jirne yamamatragatayam nishayam aushadam upayujyam. Tasmishta jirne punah dvitiye ahani pratar bhojanam iti. So this also can be followed. So this night administration of antara bhakta is not much highlighted in the texts. Just to sum up, previously consumed food is digested and then bheshaja is consumed. After metabolism of bheshaja, again food is given in the evening. It is usually hridya, deepana and manobalaka. In vyanavayu vikara it is indicated. Even in shofa, in tingling sensation all over the body, in sarvangagata kushta visarpalaya conditions, we can adopt this. Next is samudgam. Samudgam yat adavante cha bhuktasya tattu laghvalpanna yuktam pachanavaleha churnani hitmayam kampa akshepayoho vyadhi samshreye cha dukshi. Here adavante cha bhuktasya, before and after food medicine is given, that is called as samudgam. Here laghu ahara is to be considered. Pachana avaleha churnani. Here he has also specified a type of formulation for avaleha, churna and pachana aushadhi, and this is why he has mentioned hidma or hiccup, kampa or the diseases where tremors are the symptoms, akshepaka or convulsions or seizures are the symptoms. In such situation you can follow this. Samudgam nama yat aushadam upayujya pascha tatkalameva bhojanam upayujya tadanantaram tatkalameva punah tadeva aushadam iti. So this is a combination of pradbhakta and paschabhakta. Medicine is given, immediately food is given and immediately medicine is given. Tachcha hidmadishu urdhva sharire adashsharire cha yugapat sthiteshu dosheshu pachana reha churnadikam yujyam. For both urdhvagata and adhagata vikara we can use this. Adigrahanena, by the term adi that is used here, deepana anutkleshakaranam nirapayanam parigraha. So we have to consider that this medicine administered here doesn't cause any utklesha, doesn't cause any glani, doesn't cause any adverse effect, and it acts as deepana and pachana. So bheshaja is administered immediately before and after food. According to both Indu and Hemadri, in relation to food, it is to be given just before and immediately after food. So bheshaja acts like a samudga or a box here for ahara. That means below we have aushadha, above we have aushadha, in between, inside the samputa we have ahara. This helps in correcting gati vikriti of vata dosha, because vata anulomana is promoted, both urdhva and adhakati of aushadha is ensured here. So in vyana, apana, udana, vayu, vikara, in all these conditions we can follow this. For pachana, avaleha and churna preparations, for hikka, kampa, kshepakadi diseases, even in vataja prameha, in shukra dosha it is indicated. And important is we have to give light food here. So in the case of hikka, kapha and vata doshas are involved, where kapha is situated in urdhva sharira, vata in adha sharira, we can follow this. In akshepaka, doshas may be localized in pani and pada or in extremities. So samudga definitely acts on the doshas where extremities are affected. Next is muhur muhu. Muhur muhustu punaha. Punaha bhukte yat abhukteva. It is not related to the food. Repeatedly. Tat shwasa kasa hidma tritchardishu visha nimitteshu cha vikareshu. In respiratory distress where person has got an attack of dyspnea and repeated cough, trishna, the person is having a disease of polydipsia, chardi, nausea and vomiting. When person is affected with any poison, in such situation we have to give the medicine in multiple doses repeatedly, because it is an emergency situation, you will have to immediately handle it. In the commentary he says the same, muhur muhur nama yat bhukte cha abhukte cha pratikshanam upayujyate. Repeatedly, we say 2 hourly, 3 hourly, like that, unrelated to the food. Tat shwasakasadishu vishajeshu cha vigareshu yujyam. So here bhukta or abhukta avastha is not important. Even in empty stomach you can give this. There will be quick absorption, even sublingual absorption starts, faster relief is expected, higher concentration and more bioavailability of the drug is expected. So in shwasa, kasa, hikka like pranavahasrotu dushtivikara, in trishna like udakavahasrotu dushtivikara, in chardi visha like annavahasrotu dushtivyathi, we can use this. All the indications being life threatening, we need an immediate therapeutic intervention here. Next is sagrasam followed by grasantaram and nishi. Sagrasam yat grasa sampritam along with grasa. Grasa means morsel or bolus of the food. Grasantaram yat grasayoho grasiyoho madhi. One bolus is consumed, then medicine, then second bolus is consumed, then continue eating. Dvayamapi etat prananila vikrito. Both sagrasa and grasantara are indicated in pranavayumika. Tatha sagrasam churna leha vatakadikam agnidipanam vajikaranamicha upayunjita. Churna leha vataka like formulations. Formulations are also specified. For agnidipana purpose and also for vajikarana purpose are to be administered in sagrasa or grasantara kala. Grasantara, more specifically, hridroge vamanam dhumanch. Hridroge, especially hridroge. Grasantaram hridroge in cardiac disorders. Vamanam dhumancha jatrurdhva amayeshu nishaya. Vamaka dhumapana, and in the diseases pertaining to above clavicular region, that is udanavayavikara, nisha or night is the time of administration. Let us see the commentary. Sagrasam nama yat grasena grasena saha upayujyate. When administered along with the bolus, mixed with the bolus, as we always explain in the context of hingottaka churna, prathama kavala bhuktam sarpishaha churna. Along with the first bolus, hingottaka churna is added Grita is added, mixed and it is consumed. Grasantaram namayat grasayoha madhya, in between two morsels. That is, grasam upayujya, punaha bheshajam, punaha grasam iti. Etad dvayam grasam grasantaram, both these sagrasa and grasantara, cha pranaanila vikrato yojyam, specifically indicated in pranavayuvika. Ayantu vishesha, sagrasam churnadi agnidipanaya vajikaranaya cha upayujya. Among these two, sagrasa is more specific for agnidipana medicine and vajikarana medicine. Grasantaram punaha hridroga upashamana. Grasantara is more specific for the administration of medicine in cardiac disorders, like say Arjuna Arishta, Prabhakaravati, etc. Then nisha or at bed is indicated for vamakaushati, vamaka dhumapana and jatrurudhvagata disorders. So grasakala, bheshaja is administered with each and every morsel of the food. According to both Arunadatta and Hemadri, bheshaja is mixed with the morsel of the food. Sagrasa bheshaja, it facilitates absorption of the bheshaja right from the buccal mucosa itself. High concentration of the drug in systemic circulation offers rapid onset of action. Pranavayu is the main one that is affected here. Agni is stimulated. In pranavayu vikara like pinasa, ardita, trishna, shwasa, we can use this. Vajikarana bheshaja, which may be in the form of churna, avaleha, even deepaniya dravya, vati, gutika can also be administered. So normal pranavayu, as you know, regulates the intake of the food. That is, it pushes the food downwards according to Ashtangara there. So grasakala bheshaja stimulates the pranavayu. So the indriya prasadana, chitta prasadana also takes place. Because hridayendriya chitta drik, that is the function of pranavayu. So this enhances the vrishya prabhava of vrishya dravyas also. Grasantara, between two morsels medicine is given. It helps in correcting the gati vikriti of vata dosha by promoting anulomana of vata. Again in pranavayu vikara, for leha it is better time. In ardita, trishna, shwasa, hridroga, the conditions, we can use this. For kasagna, shwasagna, dhuma and vamana, we can follow nisha time. So the nisha or bedtime may be more targeted to kaphaja aggravation also. In urdhva jatruya vikara, both for lekhan and brahmana purpose, you can plan this time. According to Shargadara, nisha ananna condition is indicated. That is, before the medicine, before food, we have to give this. According to Charaka Samhita, when we talk about hridya, it is hridayaya manasehitam. So both are to be considered. So in such situation, we can indicate not only grasantara, but also nishakala, because here kapha and pitta are affected. Chiraparinamana of shamana aushadhi takes place here. That is slow digestion. Now let us just consider one more aspect here. Abhakta aushada anartha. Who is the person who is not suitable for the administration of aushadhi in abhakta kala? Tatra adye kale trishitaha pita shitam rajirne chuditaha kshamascha bheshjam varjaye. Sheshesu va ahridyam asatmyam atikshina ushna ugragantha bhuri matranjeti. So in abhakta condition, if the person is having severe thirst, or if he is weak, if he is already consumed water aplenty, then we cannot give this medicine. So you have to follow Pradbhakta and other time of administration. Now, in the next session, we will try to understand these concepts in the light of modern pharmacology. We will talk about the aspects like the relation of the time with pharmacology and therapeutics, chronopharmacology and chronotherapeutics. Along with that, we will also discuss some scientific works that have been carried out to establish the role of Aushadha Sevanakara in success of treatment. Thanks for being with me. See you again soon.